Hello friends, welcome back to this video. This is the second part of quantization error, and here in this video we are going to consider some specific cases of some specific signals. In my previous video I have already found out the generalized expression for the signal to quantization noise ratio. So the SQNR was represented by 3 PL square upon A square or 3P 2 raised to power 2N upon A square, because L was 2 raised to power N. So L square would be 2 raised to power 2N. So here I just replaced L square with 2 raised to power 2N. So in DB also I found out SQNR. So SQNR in DB was equal to 4.8 plus 6N, where N is the number of bits. So here I hope you understood up to this. So if you have still any doubt in this equation or in this equation, you can go to my previous video where I explained and derived these two equations. So here we are considering the specific cases. So first case would be So if I am representing a binary bit and I need to find out the SQNR for this binary bit representation, what would be the SQNR in this case? So here if I represent the binary bit, so the binary bit is represented like this. So here up to T by 2 I am taking it to be 1, and so up to T I am taking it to be 0. From T by 2 to T it is representing 0, and 0 to T by 2 it is representing 1. So the amplitude is A and here it is minus A. So now here I need to find out the power of this signal. I know the amplitude is A and minus A, that I have already considered. The number of levels are fixed like previously. So now I don't need to change the number of levels or number of bits. So here I need to find out the power. So the power is given by, so here I have the formula, which is 1 upon T A square into T by 2 plus, so here the amplitude is minus A square into T by 2. So this is the power of this signal. So now if I calculate it, so the power would be 1 upon T A square T upon 2 plus A square T upon 2. So T and T will get cancelled out, and here I'll be remaining out with 2 A square upon 2 T into T. So T and T will get cancelled out, 2 and 2 will get cancelled out, and the power is A square. So now in the generalized equation I just need to replace the power. So SQNR is, now instead of power I'll be putting the value A square, so it is 3 into A square into L square upon A square. So here A square and A square will get cancelled out, and here I have 3 L square, which is also represented as 3 into 2 raised to power 2N. So this is the SQNR in the case of binary bits. So this is SQNR. Now if I need to represent the SQNR in DB, so SQNR in DB is represented as 10 log of this 3 into 2 raised to power 2N. We know this value, so 10 log of 3 into 2 raised to power 2N is represented by 4.8 plus 6N. So this is the case 1, where I considered my signal to be binary bit. So now here in the next case, so this is the case 2, and here I am considering a sinusoidal signal. So the signal is like this. So here also I am taking the peak power to be A and the minimum power to be minus A. So I know how to find out the power of the sinusoidal signal. So the power is given by ARMS square upon R. So I am taking R is equal to 1. So now ARMS What is ARMS? It is A upon or A max. What is the maximum value of amplitude? It is A. So A upon root 2 is ARMS. So here I'll just replace it. So the power would be A square upon root 2 square upon 1, which is A square upon 2. So now I'll just replace the value of power with this form. So now here S, Q and R will be equal to 3 into A square upon 2 into L square upon A square. So this A square and A square will get cancelled out, and here I'll be having 1.5 L square, or I can represent it as 1.5 into 2 raised to power 2n. So now again, if I found out this in dB, so S, Q and R in dB, so it is 10 log of 1.5 into 2 raised to power 2n. So now what would be this value? This value is 1.7, around it is 1.7 plus 6n. So I take it, it is 1.76 around. So now I take it around 1.8 plus 6n. So it is nearly equal to 1.8 plus 6n. So now taking the third case, so case 3. Now I am taking a uniform distribution. Uniform distribution of x from minus a to a. So how my signal would be denoted? So here I have minus a, here I have a. So my signal is like this. So how I can represent its PDF? So it is fx of x is equal to 1 upon b minus a. It is, what is b? B is a minus of minus a, because a is also minus a. So a minus of minus a is 1 upon a minus of minus a is PDF. So it is 1 upon 2a. So now I know the PDF. So I need to find out the power. So power is given by integrating minus infinity to infinity. So it is x square into fx of x dx. So here it is not ranging from minus infinity to infinity. It is just changing from minus a to a, and fx of x is 1 upon 2a into x square dx. So I can easily integrate it. So it is 1 upon 2a into x cube upon 3, and the range is from minus a to a. So now putting the values, so here it is 1 upon 2a into a cube by 3 minus of minus a cube by 3. So now it is 1 upon 2a into 2a cube upon 3. So this will cancel out. This will be square. So here the power is given by a square upon 3. So let's put the power. So SQNR would be equal to 3 into a square upon 3. So 3 into p is a square upon 3 into l square upon a square. So this 3 and this 3 will get cancelled out. A square and a square will get cancelled out, and here I'll have l square, so which is represented as 2 raised to power 2n. So this is the SQNR. It is a very simple SQNR, so which is l square. So now if I talk about the crest factor, crest factor is equal to peak value upon RMS value. So what was the peak value in the case of sinusoid? Also only I have the crest factor. So peak value was a, and if I talk about the root mean square, so under root mean is represented by e, and square of fx square of x. So what is this? This is representing my power. So crest factor is equal to a upon under root of p. So now when a is normalized, So when a is normalized, the maximum value of a would be 1. So it is equal to 1 upon under root of p. So it's just the term which is denoting the crest factor. So crest factor is peak value upon RMS value, and we only find it in the case of sinusoidal signal, that is the case 2. So here I hope you understood all the three cases and how I can find out the SQNR in all the three cases. If you still have any doubt, you can put the doubt in the comment, because I'm winding up my session here. I hope you like this video. If you like it, share it with your friends, subscribe the channel and push the like button. Thank you.